My name is William Troyer, and I'll be discussing the benefits and consequences of conservation in the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. The decline in air quality, as well as the rise in non-native species in the region, have brought about new challenges and concerns for the conservation of the park. Imagine if 500,000 people suddenly came into your backyard. This is essentially what happened to Gatlinburg in 1934, when the Great Smoky Mountains were established as a national park by the federal government. Rising visitation rates in the park have led to rising traffic as well as air pollution. Over the past 70 years, visitations in the park have raised dramatically, as you can see, from 1931 into its highest rate in 2007 to 9.3 million people visited the park, second only to the Grand Canyon National Park. Along with air pollution caused by visitation and traffic, coal-fired power plants also are a major contributor to pollution in the park. These two sources of pollution tend to get trapped by the natural height and structure of the mountains in the park. Many of the coal-fired power plants are owned and operated by the Tennessee Valley Authority, which has come under scrutiny as of recent and is involved in a lawsuit with the state of North Carolina, which claims that the power plants owned by the Tennessee Valley Authority are a public nuisance. The pollution in recent years has become so drastic that visibility in the park has dropped 80% since 1948. Along with the pollution, the rise in non-native species is of concern, whether they are deliberately or accidentally introduced to the park. Deliberately, such as rainbow trout, which were introduced to increase the amount of fishing done in the parks, streams, and rivers, or accidentally, as in wild hogs, which have devastated natural habitat. Also, non-native plants such as kudzai, which is smothering the natural habitat and competes with native species. It may seem at times overwhelming. But with government legislation such as the Clean Air Act of 1970, and that was revised in 1990, along with the hard work of the park services to, in some cases, completely eradicate these non-native species, we are continuously working to improve the air quality in the park. The struggle to balance conservation with natural energy demands continues, with the Environmental Protection Agency proposed to adopt a rule that would make it easier for utilities to build coal-fired power plants near national parks. According to the Winston-Salem Journal in North Carolina, if the park is to survive to celebrate its next 75 years, emissions must be dramatically reduced soon. No plan that would allow increased pollution should even be considered. I think it is important to note that conservation is a continuous effort that is improving as we gain more knowledge of its benefits and consequences.